Hello guys, I am Shalita. So welcoming you to the show Pharmacy and Medical Crash Course Division in the Knowledge Club online.
At previous episode, we learned about nervous tissue structure. Today, I will discuss on function of nervous tissue. By the end of this section, you will be able to distinguish the major functions of the nervous system, sensation, integration, and response. List the sequence of events in a simple sensory receptor, motor receptor pathway.
Stay tuned up to end, because if you skip the lecture, you can miss our valuable points in between lecture. So stay tuned up to end. I am going to start today's episode. Let's start.
Having looked at the components of nervous tissue and the basic anatomy of the nervous system, next comes an understanding of how nervous tissue is capable of communicating within the nervous system. Before getting to the nuts and bolts of how this works, an illustration of how the components come together will be helpful. Imagine you are about to take a shower in the morning before going to school. You have turned on the faucet to stir the water as you prepare to get in the shower. After a few minutes, you expect the water to be a temperature that will be comfortable to enter. So you put your hand out into the spray of water. What happens next depends on how your nervous system interacts with the stimulus of the water temperature and what do you in response to the stimulus. Found in the skin of your fingers or toes is a type of sensory receptors that is sensitive to temperature called a thermoreceptor. When you place your hand under the shower, the cell membrane of the thermoreceptors changes its electrical state, that is voltage. The amount of change is dependent on the strength of the stimulus, how hot the water is. This is called a graded potential. If the stimulus is strong, the voltage of the cell membrane will change enough to generate an electrical signal that will travel down the axon. You have learned about this type of signaling before with respect to the interaction of nerves and muscles at the neuromuscular junction. The voltage at which such a signal is generated is called the threshold, and the resulting electrical signal is called an action potential. In this example, the action potential travels a process known as propagation along the axon from the axon hillock to the axon terminus and into the synaptic end bulbs. When this signal reaches the end bulbs, it causes the release of a signaling molecule called a neurotransmitter. The neurotransmitter diffuses across the short distance of the synapse and binds to a receptor protein of the target neuron. When the molecular signal binds to the receptor, the cell membrane of the target neuron changes its electrical state and a new graded potential begins. If that graded potential is strong enough to each threshold, the second neuron generates an action potential at its axon hillock. The target of this neuron is another neuron in the thalamus of the brain, the part of the CNS that acts as a relay for sensory information. At another synapse, neurotransmitter is released and binds to its receptor. The thalamus then sends the sensory information to the cerebral cortex, the outermost layer of gray matter in the brain, where conscious perception of that water temperature begins. Within the cerebral cortex, information is processed among many neurons, integrating the stimulus of the water temperature with other sensory stimuli with your emotional state. That is, you just are not ready to wake up, the bell is calling to you. Memories, like perhaps of the lab notes you have to study before a quiz. Finally, a plan is developed about what to do, whether that is to turn the temperature up, turn the whole shower off and go back to bed, or step into the shower. To do any of these things, the cerebral cortex has to send a command out to your body to move muscles. A region of the cortex is specialized for sending signals down to the spinal cord for movement. The upper motor neuron is in this region called the precentral gyrus of the frontal cortex, which has an axon that extends all the way down the spinal cord. At the level of the spinal cord at which this axon makes a synapse, a greater potential occurs in the cell membrane of a lower motor neuron. This second motor neuron is responsible for causing muscle fibers to contract. In the manner described in the chapter on muscle tissue, an action potential travels along the motor neuron axon into the periphery. The axon terminates on muscle fibers at the neurotransmitter junction. Acetylcholine is released at the specialized synapse, which causes the muscle action potential to begin, following a large potential known as an end plate potential. When the lower motor neuron exits the muscle fiber, it contracts. All of these occur in a fraction of a second. But this story is the basis of how the nervous system functions. Revise it. I am damn sure you will require less time to remember all these processes. Write me at the comment box how much you enjoyed and time take to remember the nervous tissue anatomy after viewing today's lecture. Next episode, we will discuss on the action potential of the nervous tissue. Before ending today's episode, if you like this video, please like, share and comment freely. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. If you already subscribed, then thanks a lot. And after subscribing our channel, please click on the bell button for getting the regular updates of Knowledge Club Online. I am coming with another episode very shortly for you. Till then, goodbye.